To all today, the speaker name is Meet Vaghela. He is working as a junior engineer in Jilla Panchayat Bhavnagar, and he has a very brief knowledge of how to fill the tender, how to get the contracts from government, and how the all the procedures and all the works has been done on at the government level. So without wasting the time, I'm inviting Meet Vaghela to present his presentation and give some knowledge to our students. Please, Meet.
Okay, can I start?
Yes.
Okay. Hello.
Yes, go ahead.
Okay.
Yes.
Good afternoon to all. The screen is sharing now?
Yes.
Okay.
And a full screen mode.
I can explain.
फुल स्क्रीन मोड ऊपर करी दो याने F5 दबाई दो F5
ओके फुल स्क्रीन में दिखा देना को
ना फुल स्क्रीन करो आ फुल स्क्रीन नहीं
अच्छा हम हमारे फुल स्क्रीन बता रहे हैं
ओके टाइम आ नहीं चलो गो अहेड
जो तो आवी छे हवे
यस कंप्लीट
ओके थैंक यू ओके नाउ We started from the first of the definition to the tender. Okay, it is the invitation from the owner to the contractor to execute some work at specified cost in specific. It is published in the form to the tender notice in newspaper notice board, etc. According to the cost of works. હવે કેવું થાય છે કે આજે કોઈ પણ ટાઈપનું વર્ક કે જે કઈ હોય છે એને આપણે શું છે કે અમુક બજેટમાં કે એ રીતે જો એન્જિનિયર અને કોન્ટ્રાક્ટર વચ્ચે જે કઈ આપણે વાત કરતા હોઈએ કે ભાઈ આ રીતનું કઈ કોસ્ટ છે આ રીતનું સપોઝ કોઈ પણ વર્ક કરવું છે આજે માની લઈએ કે કોઈ બ્રિજ બનાવવો છે તો એ રીતનું એનું કોસ્ટિંગ શું છે કે એમાં કઈ રીતનું વર્ક લાગશે કે એ જે કઈ ડિટેલ જે બધી આવતી છે તો એની માટે આપણે કોઈ પણ ટેન્ડર ડિસાઇડ કરીએ તો એ એક છે ઓપન ટેન્ડર પછી છે સિલ ઇન્વિટેડ ફોર ધ ઇમ્પોર્ટન્ટ ઓર હબ પ્રોજેક્ટ વાઇડ પબ્લિક ગિવન રિટન ડોક્યુમેન્ટ આર બ્રેક Next, limited tender. Only a selected number of contractors are invited to their rates. કે અમુક selected જે કોઈ કોન્ટ્રાક્ટર હોય છે એની પૂરતું બહાર પડતું
હેલો અમિત સર
સિંગલ ટેન્ડર હાજી
સ્લાઇડ ચેન્જ નથી થતી
હજી એજ સ્લાઇડ છે
હા ફર્સ્ટ સ્લાઇડ જ છે ટેન્ડર વાળી સ્ટોપ શેરિંગ કરી અને ફરીવાર શેરિંગ કરો ના નથી સ્ક્રીન શેર નથી થઈ નથી દેખાતું એક કામ કરો પીપીટી મને મેલ કરી દો હું શેર કરી આપીશ
ઓકે ઓકે મેં તમને મેઇલ કરીશ.
ઓકે ઓકે, હા એટલે શેર કરું. Okay, go ahead, Victor.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay. Next page. Next. Next, please. Next. ના, એક આગળ જોતું છે, બેકઅપ. આઈ થિંક થર્ડ પેજ. ઓકે ઓકે
ઓકે ઓકે
ઓકે. સો ટુ બી કન્ટિન્યુડ ફોર સિંગલ ટેન્ડર. ઓકે. ઇન્વિટેશન ઇઝ ધ ગીવન ટુ ધ ઓનલી ફર્મ ટુ રેન્ડર અ સર્વિસ બાય કોટિંગ ધર રેટ્સ. ઇફ ધ કોટેડ રેટ આર હાઈ, ઇટ વિલ બી નેગોશિએટેડ પીરિયડ ટુ ધ એગ્રીમેન્ટ ઓફ ધ કોન્ટ્રાક્ટ. Now last is rate contract, usually adopted for the supply of material, machine, tools and plant, etc. item to the store. It specifies the supply at a fixed rate during period of contract. The quantities are not mentioned in the type of contract and the contractor is bound to the accept any order which would be placed before it. Next. For a contract to be valid, there must be an offer from the owner in the form of tender notice to get some specified work to be executed, and there must be to the accepted form of the contractor to the execute the work. But the offer and the acceptance must be definite and legal. Next. Okay. Procedure for inviting tender. What is the procedure to the inviting tender? The first one is a preparation of the tender documents. Now the all of the documents are prepared. Issue of the notice inviting tender or tender call notice, submission and opening of tender and then scrutiny, acceptance of the tender, award of the contract. Next. Information to be given in the tender notice. The first is the name of the department inviting.
Yes, go ahead.
Okay. Sorry. Name of the designation of officer inviting tender. For the to the tender, period of availability of tender document, cost of tender document, time of completion and of contract, earnest money deposit to it, date, time and place of opening the tender, designation of opening the tender. Even in the tender document, for general condition of tender, schedule of item of work with clear specification, and third is special conditions. Legal notice in my tender is basically performed like PWD. Second, layout plan, location of work, region in which location is situated, schedule of quantity, nearest road, railway link, set of drawing, working drawings, available material in the detailed specification or reference to the standard specification for each item to the work, including the architectural and structural works. Schedule of should be by one of the in the place of supply. Set of tools and other facilities to be made available to the owner, indicating the condition, higher charges and place of delivery. Rate of supply of power and the point of supply. Location for supply. Time for compress the interval of time. Of actual personal. Weather condition of the area. Amount of EMD and the form in which is to pay. Income tax and sales tax clearance certificate. Amount of the security deposit to be paid deducted from running bills should be notified in the tender call notice. Mode of payment for work done. Power of the reject tenders without assigning reasons. Penalty condition for slow progress, delay in the completion of work. Designation of arbitration authority in case of disputes. Short tender notice. When work is completed very quickly, no contractor prefers to accept the work, the tender is floated. Okay, then a notice with short duration is again published by the client. Such a tender notice is called short tender notice. The term of condition remains the same as that ordinary tender notice. Quotation. What is quotation? For small jobs, the owner engineers give an offer to the contractor for quoting rates for works and supply required, and no earnest money deposit is required with a quotation. What is earnest money deposit? It is the amount of money to be deposited along the tender document to the department by the contractors quoting a tender. This money is guaranteed against the refusal of any contract to take up the work after acceptance of this tender. In case refusal, this amount is forfeited. Earnest money deposit of contractors whose tenders are not accepted will be refunded. It is no refund money. Okay. 1% or 2% of the estimated cost of work is the earnest money deposit. Liquidated damages. It is an amount of compensation payable by a contractor to the owner due to delayed construction. The amount of compensation is not related with real damage. This does not relieve the contractor from his obligations and the liabilities under the contract. In case if a part of the project or premise is used by the owner before it is set, the amount to be paid is reduced in proportion to the value of the part that has been utilized after issuing the certificate of occupancy. Okay. Unliquidated damages. It is the amount of compensation payable when a contract is broken. Party who suffers such a breach is entitled to the receiving amount from the party who has broken the contract. Firm price and firm period. Sometimes owner award to the work a firm or fixed rate. As the labor works to the material cost increases, it is advisable to provide escalation and the over compensation. Next firm period. Firm period time for with the firm price is valid. Next contract documents. When the tender of a contractor is accepted, an agreement between the contractor and the documents defining the rights and obligations of the owner and the contractor are attached to the agreement bond, and this is called a contract document. Each page of the contract document bears the signature of a contractor and accepting authority and any correction in its interior. The contract document must contain first title page, name of work, name of owner, name of the contractor, contract agreement number, and other contents. Index page, contents of the agreement with reference pages. Tender notice, brief description of work, estimated cost of work, date and time of receiving tender, amount of EMD and security deposit, time of completion, etc. Tender form, the bill of quantities, contractor's rate, total cost of work, time of completion, amount of security deposit. Schedule of issue of material, list of material to be issued by the owner department to the contractor with the rates and place of issue. Drawings, complete set of drawings including plan, elevation, sectional, detailed drawings, etc. All fully dimensioned. Specifications, general specification which specify the class and type of work, quality of material. Detailed specification, detailed description of each item of work including material and method to be along the quality of workmanship required. Condition of contract. First, rate of each item of work including of material, labor, transport, plant equipment and the other arrangement required for the completion of work. Amount and form of earnest money and security deposit. Third, mode of payment to contractor including running payment, final payment and refund of security money. Time of completion of work, extension of time of completion of work, engagement of subcontractor and the other agencies as contractor cost and risk, penalty for poor quality and unsatisfactory of work progress, termination of contract, arbitration of settlement of disputes. Special conditions, depending upon the nature of work, taxes, royalties including in the rates, labor camp, labor amenities, compensation up to the labor in case of accident, etc. And last is deed of pledge. Classification of contracts. First is lump sum contract, cost plus fixed percentage contract, cost plus fixed free contract, target contract, percentage rate contract, item rate contract, labor contract, joint venture contract, turnkey contract, indirect lump sum contract for floats or bungalows, and BOT system. First is lump sum contract. What is lump sum contract? In this system, the contractor undertakes the execution of specific work for definite lump sum amount within a specified time on period. On completion of the work, it is checked as per drawings and specification, and if approval, the amount is paid of contract. The quantities of various items is not measured. For the construction of cupulatives and decorative works, this system is adopted. Cost plus a fixed percentage contract. Under this system, the contractor furnishes labor and materials, completes the work from the actual total cost plus agreed percentage of it as the profit of the contract. The speed and quality of work is maintained in this system, but there is always tremendous wastage of materials, as the contractor's aim is to the increase the total cost of the work. This system is adopted only in the case of emergency. Couple of fixed free contract. In this system, a fixed fee is given to the contractor's profit of the total cost of work. This is controlled to tendency of the contractor to increase the cost of project unnecessarily. Smaller the completion time, more is the profit, and the contractor hurry to complete the work and the quality of workmanship it not maintained. This system is not generally used. Target contract. The contractor is paid fixed fee on a prime cost basis For the work performed under the contract and the addition, he receives a percentage on the saving effected against either a period agreed to the total cost of target value or at without changing the specification. It was that by proper management of the work, the contractor can reduce the cost of work, but due to the increase in the cost, material is never materialized and hence this system not getting popularity. Percentage rate contract. In this system, contractor are required to the quote single percentage, either higher job or lower, at which he want to the execute the job. Yes, continuity of the tenders become easier and as cement and steel is usually supplied by the department, chances of manipulation is less. This the mostly adopted system of the contract in the different department of state. Item contract. Here the contract is the payment depending on the date at which he was quoted every item of the work. It was rather difficult to the quality of the tender submitted by the matters, and the system was modified. And now the department the item along with their quantities and the binders are required to quote a percentage at which he can execute this item. Labor contract. This is the most commonly adopted system for the construction of private individual buildings in small cities. The contractor arranges all of necessary labor, tools and plant equipment required. The materials are supplied by the owner and he appoints an engineer to supervise the work, maintain the quality, economy in construction. This system is suitable in work of government department as they are in privileged position to buy larger quantities materials of cheap rates. Joint venture contract. In case of work important project, the construction work can be categorized into different parts. And each part can be given to the specialized contract in that field. This method improves the quality of work and the project can be completed within a short period of time. Thus, the project will be divided among different contracts and hence joint venture system of contract development. Turnkey contract. In this system, all the works related to the project, including designing, planning, execution, are to be done by the contractor. Once the project is completed, it is hand over to the owner. The owner has completely the transaction works and occupies the structure by simply turning the key. Example, opening the door. Lump sum contract for flat and bungalows. In this system, the rate of construction per square meter of clean area is jointly fixed by the contractor and the owner, which includes contractor's profit also. Once the agreement is made, the contractor start the work, receive payment at regular intervals. During the different stages of work, sometimes the specification drawings are prepared by the builder. BOT system. Build, operate, and transfer is a new system in which the land is acquired by the government and the contractor is asked to build the structure and then operate it until the collects of the money he has spent to the construction as fees from the users. Once the construction quote is recovered, the structure is handed over the owner. No payment is made to the contractor by the government. Security is provided to the builder by the government regarding law order problems if any. Bridges and road are usually constructed by adopting this system of contract. Toll is collected from the users, passing over it by the contractor, recover the construction of cost. Okay, security deposit. Security deposit is the amount of the contractor has to deposit with the owner before awarding a work. After this tender is accepted, the amount to be generally 5 of 10% of estimated cost of the project is inclusive of the EMD already deposited into the contract along the tender. This will be refunded to the after the completion of project. No interest is paid on security deposit. The contractor has fulfilled all the terms and conditions laid down in the contract, maintained. Quality, speed, satisfactory. If he fails to do so, a part of all security deposit is the by the department. If there is any fault in the construction and the contractor refuses the demolish and reconstruct, then the department will carry out the work using the security deposit. If the cost of project is a hug amount, the contractor is made the deposit only 50% of the amount in the initial stage. The rest of security deposit deduct into the installment from the running bills of contract. Security deposit is not collected in case of contract for supply of material, as the supplied material become the security. Qualification of the contractors. First, registration of contractors. The contractor must get himself registered in the Department of Government for which he is interested to the take up works. Government contracts are to do government job is awarded. Contracts are classified according to the registration and registration fees, and depending on this, they can undertake works of certain amount. To get contractor to be registered under certain class, he has to apply to the authority first. The following documents, the first one is current income tax certificate, work certificate for the work performed during the last 3 years and those in progress, solvency certificate and appropriate amount, attached copy to the partnership and power of attorney on stamp paper if needed, undertaking for employment of the class and staff, application in duplicate with all documents, attached photos of all the partners if any. Pre-qualification of contract. Sometimes work are awarded on the basis to the quotation invite of selected vendors who are considered suitable for that job. This method is the pre-qualification and save a lot of time. In the advertisement itself, it must be mentioned that only contractors having experience in the particular work should submit the tender. Characteristics. These include the characteristics of properties of material, machines, manpower, etc. used for the work. For example, if the material used in concrete, slump, strength, water cement ratio, etc. are checked frequently. Quality control in construction. The basic element quality are quality characteristics, quality of design, quality of components. Quality characteristics. These include the characteristics and properties of the materials, machine, manpower, etc. used for the work. Next. Quality of design. No design can produce to the preferred result. Hence, the design standard that define a material such as the dimension, strength, etc. and the tolerance. The accepted variation from the standard are also specified. For example, if the material is used is concrete, in addition to the specified requirement to the strength, the range of variation permitted no more than 20% of the sample can have value less of one specific. If very high standard of quality and strict tolerance limit are set, then this will increase to the cost of the project. Okay. Thank you.
Okay, a very good knowledge has been delivered by the Mit sir.
Yes.
And a very good practical knowledge is there for our students. It will surely help to our students. So, I want to thank Mr. Mit Vaghela to deliver such a wonderful lecture. And I'm sure the knowledge and this practical knowledge will surely help us to encourage our students to go into the government field and in contractors as a contractors. And he is a very busy person, Meet sir, but as once I have called you, they never refuse my call and is always ready to deliver a lecture for me only. I think this is its third or fourth lecture in Parul University, and every time he comes with a tremendous knowledge and a tremendous and very practical knowledge with us. So students get benefit, always gets some benefits. So I'm thanking you. Thank you very much, Mit sir.
Thank you very much. Most welcome.
Oh, okay, Mit sir. You can leave.
Thank you. Good day.
Yes. Jiten sir.